Both of my parents grew up in Ethiopia. At the time, there wasn't much else to do besides being outside. That was like where you wanted to be. My dad told me he would always be outside, playing soccer or catching different kinds of bugs. I've never been like an outside person as much as I wanted to be because I've always had like video games to keep me entertained, TV shows, movies. During the pandemic, you know, everyone's been feeling like you've been reliving the same day, going through the same thing, whether it's school, work, some people were online the whole year. But being able to go in nature, you're able to experience something new every day. My name is Kaleab, and I'm going into my senior year at David Douglas High School. I live in the Lents area, which is in Southeast Portland. I'm part of a group called Lents Youth Initiative, and through that group, I was able to go to Westmoreland Park on a dragonfly survey. Before I went on the survey, I was terrified of dragonflies and all flying insects. I really would like go inside, literally, if I saw a dragonfly in my backyard, and I wouldn't come out until the coast was clear. I came with one of my friends, and he's explaining to me that they're not gonna bite, they're not gonna hurt me. I really didn't care. I was extremely nervous. Just the thought that they could just fly into my ear or fly into my mouth. I just didn't see myself doing that. Catching a dragonfly with my hands couldn't be me. But when I caught my first one, I wasn't like a little damselfly, I was a huge dragonfly, so I was like, oh no. We try to make a little opening through the net that we can stick our hand in perfectly, and then we try to hold the dragonfly by the wings in a way that it doesn't get hurt. It was really loud buzzing, so I was afraid, but I knew it wasn't gonna bite me, and I just went all in and grabbed it. It looked like an alien, honestly. The eyes were on the side of its head. I've never seen anything like it. Even my mom didn't believe that I actually did it until I showed her the pictures, and she was like, wow. They were proud of me for getting over my fear. You can get a lot closer than you think and admire without being afraid. And admiration really opened my eyes. We were able to analyze whether or not the environment was holding up to what it's supposed to do. And we learned that it was doing a pretty good job. There were a lot of dragonflies, a lot of damselflies, and they seemed pretty healthy. Keeping the environment healthy is not a specific race, it's not a specific gender. Everyone should be included. But as a black male coming from a first generation immigrant family, it's really hard to make space for this kind of thing because you're worried about getting through the day, getting through the year, fitting in with people of this country because you don't know where you fit in. You're worried about fighting systemic racism, police brutality. But I think it's not fair to always have thoughts about survival. We should be able to enjoy things that everyone else enjoys as well. I think it's important that programs like the Lents Youth Initiative get support so that they have the resources to reach out to more people. Nature, it belongs to everyone. You notice new things, you pick up new things, and there's always an endless amount of exploration to be done. And nature is the best place to, you know, just be who you are.